Welcome back to our YouTube channel. So these are the questions that were asked in SLET 2019 physics question paper. So the first question is, a particle is being acted upon by an inverse square force, which is given as F vector equal to minus k by r square r vector, r cap, sorry. The corresponding Hamiltonian of the system is. So if you observe this four option carefully, the kinetic energy part, that is p square divided by 2sm part, is same for all of them. And the potential energy part is actually varying. So given F vector equal to minus k by r square r cap, so we know F, that is the force, is the negative gradient of the potential. So this is minus del V by del r. So V equal to minus integration F dot dr. So you just put the value of F, which is minus k by r square dot dr. And if you do the integration, ultimately you will get minus k by r. So this is the potential energy term. So a minus k by r is in the option B. So option B is correct. So option B holds. So this is the second question. So given a wave with the dispersion relation omega equal to ck plus m, where k and m both are greater than 0, and the question is, which of the following statement is true? So in the four option, there are some group velocity and phase velocity, and the relation between them we have to find out. So the phase velocity, we know vp equal to omega by k, and the group velocity vz equal to d omega by dk. So omega is given, which is ck plus m. So when you do the derivative of it, so d omega by dk, so you will get c. Now vp equal to omega by k, put the value of omega, which is ck plus m divided by k, and this is c plus m by k, and you know c is vz, that is the group velocity, vz plus m by k. And ultimately from this you can say that is vp equal to vz plus m by k. So vp is greater than the vz, or in other words, vz is less than vp. So option B is correct, and this is the group velocity is less than the phase velocity. So this is the question number 3. Here A and B are two variables, independently measured quantities having values A equal to 100 plus minus 3, B equal to 45 plus minus 2. And we have to find out the standard error del Z for Z equal to A minus twice B. So let's find the value of Z. So Z is A minus twice B. So the value of A is 100. So 100 minus 2 into B is 45. So 45, that is 100 minus 90 equal to 10. So all the first three options has 10 value, 10, 10, 10, but the last one has 5. So this is not correct. So let's find the del Z term. So del Z equal to Z root over of del A divided by Z whole square plus 2 into del V divided by Z whole square. So 2 comes from this term. Okay. So Z we have already find out which is 10. So 10 and del A equal this is the error term 3, and del B, this is the error term plus minus 2. So 3 and here 2, and after doing this calculation you arrived at the result, which is 5. So option B is correct here. So in the question number 4, if P and Q are position and momentum variables, which one of the following is not a canonical transformation? And here you see this is not a canonical transformation. Okay, so we know for a canonical transformation, the Poisson bracket of QP equal to 1, and this is the definition of Poisson bracket, which is del Q by del Q, del P by del P, minus del Q by del P, del P by del Q. And let's check for different options. So for the first option, if you calculate the Poisson bracket, then ultimately you will get 1. So it holds, it's actually canonical transformation. For B, it's also 1, so it's also correct. And for C, you see, for C, you'll not getting 1 but you have minus 1. So this is the option, and we don't go for D as we have already arrived our answer. So this is the question number 5. The solution of the equation. So three equations are given and we have to find the solution by matrix method. So we have already given the solution. So among these four, one is the correct answer. So let's check which one is correct. So if you put the values of x1, x2, x3 in these three equation, then equation 1 is satisfied by the first option, equation 2 is also satisfied, equation 3 is also satisfied. So all the equations are satisfied here. But if you go for option B, equation 2 is not satisfied. For option C, equation 1 is not satisfied. And for D, equation again 1 is not satisfied. So option A is correct. So if you really want this type of videos more, then please comment below. And you can also subscribe our channel. Hit a like if you really like our videos. And you can also share our videos with your friends. So thank you for watching.